guys, it is Yank here with 47 North Gaming. I am back with another episode of Project Cars. This is actually the penultimate round. This is race 5 of 5 in the GT5 Championship. So, here we go. We've got a points lead basically guaranteeing us the championship, but we are going to still go for the win, still go for that performance, and try to get a contract into GT4. So we're back at Donington. I've got qualifying going here, but this is a different layout than what we saw in race, I believe it was race 2 or 3. So, here we go. So we ended up only turning a couple laps before the rain came down. I decided to park it before we did damage. So
green, go.
Didn't end up getting a quick lap in when we were running slicks. Thank you. still pretty good amount of rain, though. Final lap, this is a sprint race. This is a long track, so it's only a 2-lapper for this sprint race, which is fine. And then they do. We're up to 7. Finish back of the pack once again in a sprint race, and we have to do all of our work during the main event. Won't be the first time for us, that's for sure. We're very well aware. But again, having that points buffer from earlier in the season is not a bad thing for us. I'm gonna get cut on the track one. Ooh, shit. Yep, we're finishing 20th. No ifs, ands, or buts about that. Yes, we get ready for the main events. about going away. Boss's instructions.
Box this lap. You've got to come in for your mandatory change of tyres now.
What am I gonna put on? I'm gonna put on a wet. Oh, that's all our options. Okay.
Boom.
All right. Guess we're putting on wets then. I guess for GT5 it makes it simple. Alright, away we go. Let's go get this one. Alright, we're in P6. What looked like it was doing, punch you. Ooh, crazy. Looks like a tire blew out. I think it just bottomed out funny. Let's go make the best of it. I see this isn't a must win situation, this is just a must finish situation, so I think we can at least do that. Process. We will destroy these tires, but...
You've got some pressure from the guy behind. You'll need to brake as late as you can. You may need to cover the inside line.
Guess who cares if we get championship money doing this? Or the team's getting championship money doing this. Who cares if they're having to pay for destroyed tires. It's not like we're going to reuse them after this race anyway. P10 on wets in the dry. Oh, we got the slicks on, right?
Okay, mate, you're on his tail. Let's try and nail him on this lap. Force an error. He's under big pressure. You can take it.
Thank goodness the auto glitches. That's the case. Double down. May have been the tire pressure, but it's not up to snuff yet.
Nice one, that was the fastest lap of the race.
It also could be that I'm just not used to having to push it now. Now I can push it. So let's go for it. Cooling off and everything. Good chance to run some fast laps. Sun setting on the season. I think we got this championship in the bag, and hopefully a driver contract or GT4 with somebody anyway.
Reeling him in, this is great stuff. Line him up and squeeze past.
Alright. Caught up with him, now we're gonna set him up for pass. Got the next set of tail lights in front of me. Set it. Reeling those guys in. A lap and a half to go. See if we can get it to top five. And you gotta notice these cars, they do pick up grime throughout the course of the race. Ooh, aye. Yeah, you can see the exhaust soot on the tail there, along with rubber buildup and such. I wish the rest of the cars showed this kind of detail. I think they show minimal rubber gains, but I think part of that's probably just to try to be, you know, save a little bit of graphic processing power, since this game is pretty intensive in that regard. But it just makes it beautiful, makes it realistic.
That's 8th place, good job, you're gaining on 7.
State from them for me to hit
P5.
Okay,
we've got a little bit of pressure from the guy behind, so it may be time to start covering the inside line.
Fun fact, that blue and white car that we've been for the last couple of goes, the guy that's behind us, that was the other team that was interested in signing with me to start the career, so it's just kind of another little fun tidbit. Just that much more to be like, ha. And then for this team to be like, ha, we got him, rather than you got him. It's been a successful team, so I can't complain. Equipment got us in the championship run. Heck, our teammate is second place in points, so I can't complain too hard about that. After all the trials this racing weekend, we're gonna come away with a top 10, which is, you know, not amazing, but can't complain either. So, and the big important thing is the championship, of course. So there's the finish. Pick up our points there. Did get a bonus point for the fastest lap in that race.
Fantastic.
And there we go.
You've won your first championship. Make sure to check your inbox, as you will no doubt have received new contract offers. You can also renew your contract with your current team and stay on for another season.
There's our championship. Not a bad looking trophy, if I do say so myself. Finished 35 points ahead of our teammate, so got enough of a buffer anyway to stay ahead decisively. But we're gonna go back to the career dashboard, look at some of the messages, and then probably call it a day. Congratulations! Driver network updated, and I have new mail. New mail. Alright, we'd like to invite you to come and participate in the Glencairn Kart Club Trophy on behalf of Galario or whatever. The event starts on the 11th and it will be great to have you behind the wheel representing our team. Alright. So we'll go into career here. So this is a one-off.
Welcome to your first invitational event. Invitational races cover a wide variety of cars. Early vintage open.
Well, I will
racers,
actually
cars,
cut the video here, so I will catch you in the next one, and we'll be doing this kart event.
These events do not
in the next one. But until then. We'll be right back.